Well, when we look at the typical American diet, we know that most of us tend to consume 10 times more omega-6 fatty acid than we do omega-3. The result of that? Increased inflammation. We know as well that there is competitive inhibition. The same pathway that metabolizes omega-6 will metabolize omega-3. So it kind of makes sense that if indeed you're taking in more omega-6 than you do 3, there's going to be more selective uptake of the omega-6 and less of the beneficial effect of the omega-3. Or in other words, if somebody is consuming more omega-6 fatty acids and more of that is being metabolized and utilized, there is less omega-3 fatty acid available to be converted to EPA and DHA, therefore conferring less of this protective, preventative, proactive inflammatory response. So we're going to talk in a little bit more detail about this idea of competitive inhibition. So when we look at the omega-6 fatty acids, what do they include? Linoleic acid, and that is corn oil, safflower oil, sunflower oil, or basically the vegetable oils that you find in the grocery store. It also includes gamma linolenic acid, which is borage oil, or what we call black currant seed oil. And then the other is the arachidonic acid, which primarily is derived from meat. The issue with these omega-6 fatty acids is that they can create the pro-inflammatory prostaglandins and the leukotrienes, which have an effect in terms of increasing inflammation. So if we have a diet that is comprised more of the omega-6 fatty acids, that is a problem because we're going to have increased inflammation.